Hello. I'm going to walk you through some configuration options for ML in the NetData agent to enable the Anomaly Advisor feature in NetData Cloud. So if you're in NetData Cloud and you see this Anomalies tab here and you don't have ML enabled on your agents, you'll see a landing page like this which says your nodes are not configured for ML. So to configure nodes for ML is basically a one-line configuration change for now. In the future, NetData Agent may have this turned on by default, but as of kind of initial launch, it's just behind a configuration variable. And so what you need to do there is you need to check out the docs in Laren. You can find the guide if you go to laren.netdata.cloud and you go to docs. In the configuration section, you'll see a submenu for configuring machine learning on your agent. And there's a lot of information in here about kind of what happens, what's going on behind the scenes, how it's working, some of the key concepts. But the main thing we're interested in here is configuration. And so to enable the anomaly detection capabilities of the NetData agent, basically you need to just change this one line here from enable no to enable yes. So you would need to go into your netdata.conf file and just make this one line change, restart netdata, and then your agent will start training anomaly detection models for every metric, and that will then be the foundations then that the anomaly advisor feature in NetData Cloud will use to give you unsupervised anomaly detection across your infrastructure. So there's various ways to do this, and there's lots of kind of configuration parameters in here, but I'll quickly go through some of the main typical ones, but there's a lot more detail in the docs here in terms of for each parameter there's a description, there's the minimum, the maximum, and some tips on kind of when you might want to play with one versus the other. But primarily they're all kind of set to same defaults is one of the main ethos of the NetData agent, is to have same defaults. So there's not a whole lot of configuration to be done. It's just for if you want to then tweak things, you can. So in terms of configuration examples, there's a couple of different ways you can enable ML on your NetData agent. They're mostly, this picture here kind of shows the main ways you might sort of set this up, the main topologies as such. So in this case, we have three children streaming to a parent, and in child, you know, child zero has the ML enabled, child one has the ML enabled, and child two has the ML disabled for whatever reason. So one example could be maybe child two is like an IoT device that's just not powerful enough to do the ML, and you might have to have it disabled and stream it to a parent. And then you can enable ML on the parent itself for that child. But typically it's kind of up to you, the user, to decide. The overhead, there's very little overhead of the ML, the way we've implemented it. Typically, you know, about 1% CPU, if even. And so it's a case of just flexibility for whatever your preference is. If you want to run the ML on your parent, you can, or if you don't have a parent, you can also just run the ML on the child itself at the edge, and it shouldn't really be noticeable at all. And so what we have here is I will show you, I have a couple of nodes here that match this setup. So I've got a parent node, I've got an ML enabled node, and I've got a ML disabled node. So what I'll do is I'll just go in and look at the NetData conf in each of them. So if I start with the this node here, which is ML disabled, we can CD into the NetData directory, and then we can use the helper script to edit our NetData config, NetData conf. And when we look in here, you'll see there's actually not much going on here because it's kind of a minimal config. And all we're doing is the ML is set to disabled here. So it's enabled equals no, basically. And what we're going to do for this node is the ML for this node is going to run on the parent. And NetData Cloud is going to just kind of make sense of all that when it comes to the Anomaly Advisor. So that's the ML disabled node. And if I look into the node with ML enabled, that's this one. And we can do the same thing. We can cd into the netdata directory, use our helper file to play around with the conf. And we can see a little bit of a different configuration in here. We have enabled equals yes. And so for at a minimum, this is all you would need to do, is just set this from no to yes and uncommented if it's sometimes it might be commented. And then there's a couple of other parameters here. And in this case, I'll walk through each one quickly. This maximum num samples to train is basically saying the maximum amount of data we're going to train on is 4 hours. That's the default at the moment. And this minimum num samples to train basically means as soon as we have 15 minutes worth of data, we're going to train a model for that metric. It's probably not going to be a great model because you've only got 15 minutes, but this is what I do sometimes to make them train as quick as possible, basically, so that if you're starting with a fresh node, what I do here is I train every 15 minutes and have at least 15 minutes to train a model. This is the quickest way you can get up and running with it. But typically the default here would be to leave this only till we have 3600, so 1 hour's worth of data is the minimum to get a decent model. And this train every is also 3600 by default, so every hour. So every hour NetData will train in once you enable this to yes, in a steady state, then NetData will train every hour. It'll train on the most recent 4 hours of data for every metric. And they're the main things of interest here for this particular node. We'll go through the parent config next. So if I look at the parent node that's in here, we can see we can do the same thing, cd into our NetData directory, sudo netdataconf, and this is very similar to the last configuration. The only difference here now is because we're running on a parent, I'm now going to use this host to skip from training parameter. And so this particular parent has two hosts streaming to it. It has the previous two hosts we looked at, so the one with the ML disabled and the ML enabled are both coming into this parent. And so to avoid doing the ML on both the parent and the ML enabled, I'm telling NetData here to ignore this particular host when it comes to the ML that's happening on the parent node itself. So the idea here is this parent node, ML demo parent, is going to do ML for itself and for the ML disabled node that's streaming to it. But there's no point in it doing it also for this ML enabled node, because this node is doing it its own ML at the edge. You could, of course, have it that, you actually could run the ML on both the edge and on the parent, and then NetData Cloud will end up essentially kind of averaging out those two models. So it's totally fine to do that, but it's just, it's in some sense, it's potentially wasteful of resources. So the configuration here is the idea here is just to show all the different options as well. So that's kind of the main goal. So once we do these, once we have these configuration changes, we would just restart NetData. And then what you will then see in NetData is in the overview screen, if I look in my demo space here, in the overview screen, you will see that a new menu appears called anomaly detection. And this is telling you kind of which nodes in this room are actually running anomaly detection and have trained anomaly detection models that are predicting every second, that are given these, anomaly rates and anomaly bits, all the kind of concepts covered in here, basically, in terms of what's going on in the background. Every second, in addition to the raw metric, NetData will also produce this anomaly bit, which is a 1 or a 0 to say if the recent data is anomalous or not. So what you would see then is in here, if I look by node, even you don't have to necessarily look by node, but the main thing to note is after you restart NetData, at some point this trained dimension count will start increasing. And once it increases so that it's trained, as many models as possible. Not all models will train. Some models won't train dimensions if they have just constant values. There's no point in training them. There's a few kind of optimizations like that. But what you should see is that this trained count it stays at zero and then kind of starts to rise over time as NetData starts training your metrics. And then in a steady state, you should have a chart that looks like this, which is kind of most of your metrics are trained. And you can also see kind of some counts for anomalous and normal and anomaly rate below. But once you have all your nodes with ML configured and ML training, then you should be able to, when you come back into the anomalies tab here, you should see that actually you start to have some charts that you can now use the anomaly advisor on. And the main thing here is that once you see a spike of interest, you can kind of highlight the area of interest, and the anomaly advisor will then make use of all the anomaly rates on these nodes in the back end and give you a sorted list of which metrics and dimensions are considered most anomalous in any particular window of interest across your whole room. So if I took an example here, if I look at this kind of blue spike, let's have a look, ML enabled. I'll filter just for this node, and let me highlight specifically around this region. So this particular 2 minutes of interest, it seems like the anomaly rate jumped up to about 3.2% of all the metrics were considered anomalous. And if I highlight this area, I can see what turned anomalous at this time. And actually just looking at this here, I can tell what this is. I installed the Gremlin agent. So Gremlin is a chaos engineering agent that you can run to run chaos attacks. And I actually, this is probably me. I went and I initialized the Gremlin agent here, and you can see that it sort of jumps right to the top of the list in that I went in and I did some Gremlin CLI commands, the agent came alive. And so that's actually what was the root cause of this spike here, was me actually on the system tinkering around doing some configuration changes to turn on this, enable this Gremlin agent actually for another demo I'm going to do, which is where we actually do a chaos attack on the NetData agents and then trace that through the Anomaly Advisor tab. But you can kind of see I've basically done that here indirectly by the actual configuration itself is what's after kind of increasing the anomaly rates, and NetData picked up Gremlin automatically because it kind of has, it understands the processes Gremlin runs under. And so you can see it actually, this is like the equivalent of somebody coming in and installing a new app. You can see it's right at the top of the list here basically. So yeah, that's a quick look at the configuration setup. How this all works then is that you'll notice in here we actually have anomaly rates for all three nodes. The main thing here is that actually we have anomaly rates for this ML disabled node. So if I just look at this node here, what we can see here is that we actually have anomaly rates for this node, and it behaves as if we have the anomaly detection running like any other node. And how this works is because the let me find a big kind of an interesting spike here if I can, if there's any, maybe this one. I'll just zoom in and see. I'll zoom in a little bit. Yeah, so I can see here some disk stuff going on. These anomaly rates are actually coming from they're being the ML work is being done on the parent, and it's being NetData Cloud can understand that the ML disabled instance on the parent is contributing the anomaly scores here to the anomaly advisor. So there's no ML actually running on this ML disabled node. The ML is all happening on the parent, but NetData Cloud kind of just makes sense of all that for you. So you can see that actually, okay, the ML is running on the parent, but in here it's kind of brought back together where you can see the anomaly rate tells you the anomaly rate of the particular dimension or metric, but then you also see the raw data of the metric, which is also streaming to the parent. So this is a good use case where maybe if you have nodes that you don't want to run the ML on the edge for various reasons, that's totally fine. You can kind of run it on the parent and it should all just work in the Anomaly Advisor tab in NetData Cloud. And if we get really kind of dig into that in a little bit more detail, we can look at the parent node itself and just see what it's doing. So let me jump over. I have a few few dead nodes in this room. Let me come into this one. And I have in here, if we look at the dashboard just for the parent, we can see that in the net data monitoring section, we can actually see there's an ML menu, which will show you the CPU usage of each thread on this parent. And also there's in the ML, there's a training step and a prediction step. And so this is showing you the CPU usage of each thread on each instance. So we can see here, for instance, let's see, here's the training thread CPU usage for this ML disabled node on the parent. So in this case, there's two. There's one for the parent itself, which is this guy, and then there's one for the ML disabled node that is streaming to this parent, which is this one here. So this is way kind of just shows if this is mostly for diagnostics and stuff. If you want to see how much overhead the ML is using on the parent, what the impact of these two threads are in terms of CPU usage. That's also kind of in here. It's more like a diagnostic, but this is just so you can see, if you want to sort of dig in to see exactly what's going on, you can see the actual node instance level tricks in here in the diagnostic section, in this ML section in net data monitoring. But yes, typically you don't really, you know, once you've done your configuration, it shouldn't really matter. It should just flow through to the Anomaly Advisor tab here, so you can work away and hopefully find your anomalies quicker and get back to your day. So yeah, thanks. That's all we want to go through today on the configuration of the ML.